Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. This is another session of quadratic equation. We are discussing quadratic equation and I hope you have watched all the previous classes. And now this is, we are going to use quadratic formula and on the basis of that we are going to solve some question. So let me discuss, in the previous class we have discussed some questions related to quadratic formula. But that was the simpler one. Let us today discuss some good questions, that is creative questions on the basis of quadratic formula, and let me solve and show you how to deal with all those questions. So first question I am writing here today is x minus 1 upon x minus 2 plus x minus 3 upon x minus 4 is equal to 3 1 by 3. And it is written, this condition is x is not equal to 2 or 4. This is what usually have been written. This meaning is this, that is a condition, constants it is written. Answer cannot be 2 or 4. Why? Because if x will 2, then 2 minus 2 is 0 and something divided by 0 is not defined. Similarly, when x is equal to 4, then 4 minus 4 would be 0, and in that case, this equation will not be defined. So, this is the constraints, restrictions which have been given. Apart from this, some other values when will come, that all will be accepted except this 2 and 4. So, let me solve this question. Should I go for what to do? First of all, we will take the LCM of this. Simple idea is that we will take the LCM and we will write here x minus 2, x minus 4, and this can be written as x minus 1, x minus 4 plus x minus 3 and x minus 2, and this is 3, 3 is 9 and 1, 10 by 3. Some other ideas are also there, but I am dealing with such a way that which will come in your mind without any other thinking. In simple thinking, how you can interpret, in that way I am solving. Otherwise, I have so many ideas to solve these questions, even in seconds as well. But I am telling that what I am telling, I mean it. So here it will be x square minus 5x plus 4. Why this will come? X into x square, x into 4 minus 4x, and here it will come minus x, that would be minus 5x. And minus 1 multiplied by minus 4 is equal to 4. This will be also x into x square minus 2x minus 3x minus 5x and 3 to the 6 whole divided by, that will again come x square minus 2x minus 4x minus 6x and 4 to the 8, that is 10 by 3. So moreover, after simplifying this, I can write this x square plus x square is 2x square minus 5x minus 5x minus 10x, and 6 plus 4 is also 10, and divided by whole things multiply by 3, because this 3 will come this side and 10 is in here, and that will multiply by this x square minus 6x plus 8. So finally, the thing will come up like 3 into 2, 6x square, minus 10 into 3, 30x, plus 10 into 3, 30, and here it will be 10x square, minus 60x, plus 80. If I would subtract this one, this will go this side, 10x square minus 6x square will be equal to 4x square, 4x square, minus 30 will come this side, it will be plus 30. So minus 60 plus 30 will remain minus 30x, and this will come this side, it will be negative. So 80 minus 30 is 50, that will be 0. If I divide this and 2 by 2, this equation will come like 2x square minus 15x plus 25 is equal to 0. Now you can split middle term, 50, 25 into 2 would be 50. And what are the other two factors? Because product is 50, so two negative terms should be there, and that will be 10 and 5. So easily one can say that the factors are 10 and 5. So you can write 2x square minus 10x minus 5x minus plus 25 is equal to 0. Right? So if I would take 2x common, what will happen? 2x, if I would take common, then here it will be 2x into x minus 5. And if I took 5 common, x minus 5 is equal to 0. And finally, what will come as the answer? Finally, answer will come like x minus 5, if I would have taken common, that will come x minus 5 and 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. So answer of x will be, if x minus 5 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 5, and 2x minus 5 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 5 by 2. So x is equal to 5 and 5 by 2, these are the two answers. Either I can write answer x is equal to 5 or x is equal to 5 by 2. So two answers came in here, 5 and 5 by 2. This is the answer of this question, and we can write like this. I hope you got it. Now the next questions I am telling here, I am taking here, that is question number 2. And this question, 4 root 3 x square plus 5x minus 2 root 3 is equal to 0. I have taken this question, and you have to deal with such questions. How to deal with? Even by method of factorization we can deal with 8 into 2, 4 into 2, 8, and root 3 into root 3 is 3. So 8 into 3 is 24. Now factor of 24, that the product is negative, so it can be split into one positive and one negative term. Positive term must be bigger, negative term must be smaller. Now you can take it as 8 and 3, 8, 3 is 24. So you can write this 4 root 3 x square plus 8 x minus 3 x minus 2 root 3 is equal to 0. Can I write like this? 4 root 3 into 2 root 3, that is 24 minus 24. 8 into minus 3, that is also minus 24. So I can write like this. What I can take maximum common out of it? 4 and x. So I can take 4x common from these two. So what is left there? Root 3x left, and 4 I have taken common, so left 2, and x has been already taken common. Now what I can took common maximum from out of these two? Root 3 can be taken common only, and root 3, then what is left here? Root 3 left out of 3, and 1x also left. Because negative sign has been taken common, so inside this sign will change, and this will be 2 only, that is equal to 0. Right now? Got this point? Okay. So root 3x plus 2, root 3x plus 2, these two are present in both the equations, so I can take common root 3x plus 2, and what is left here? 4x minus root 3, that is equal to 0. So this implies root 3x plus 2 is equal to 0, or 4x minus root 3 is equal to 0. Root 3x is plus 2 is equal to 0 means root 3x is equal to minus 2, and x is equal to minus 2 by root 3, or here 4x is equal to root 3, so x is equal to root 3 by 4, and therefore x can have value either minus 2 by root 3 or root 3 by 4. So solution set can be written as, there are two solutions, one is minus 2 by root 3, other one is root 3 by 4. So even we can solve this question by quadratic formula as well, but I used to vary the methods. So I used to solve the questions by different method, so that you will be able to analyze that any method can be adopted depending upon the nature of the questions or situation. Even this question can be also solved by using quadratic formula, but I given the preference for factorization method. So let me write the third question. The third question I am writing here, that is 36x square minus 12ax plus a square minus b square is equal to 0. Right? So publicity question, which formula you should take up. Either you can take on factorization method or you can take on quadratic formula. It will be difficult for you to do this like this form. So it will be better to go ahead with the quadratic formula. What is A here? 36. What is B here? Minus 12A. In place of B, this is minus 12A. And in place of C, B can be written as capital B, because B already, small b has been used. And capital C, if I describe, that is A square minus B square. Now, you have to find D. And D is what? B square minus 4AC. B square minus 4AC, I can write here. So, minus 12A whole square minus 4 into 36 into A square minus B square, I can write here. Now, 12 square is 144, A whole square is A square. Due to A square, the negative sign would be positive. 36 multiplied by 4 is also 144. And 144 multiplied by A square, 144 A square, minus minus plus, 144 B square. So these two are cancelled and 144 B square left. Now, according to quadratic formula, I can write minus B plus minus root under D upon 2A, right? So, I may write here, take the privilege to write minus 12A here, minus minus 12A plus minus root under 144 B square divided by 2 into 36. That can come 12A minus minus plus, plus minus 144 square root of 144 is also 12. B square will come outside, that will be B divided by 72. If I would take 12 common, that will come A plus minus B, and 12 can be taken common and divide 72, it will come 6. So answer of this questions will be, and therefore x can have value, therefore x can have value either a plus b by 6 or a minus b by 6, and that will be answer of this question. So that will be answer of this question, a plus b by 6, a minus b by 6. Here, by solving this question by factorization method, it would be quite difficult, but taking quadratic formula, it will be easy. So you may think that when I should take up, I have given you the idea that quadratic formula is Brahmastra. Whenever any other method not come in mind easily, you can use quadratic formula and it is always safe. So you can do that. Now, take on question number 4. Question number 4 I am taking here. 1 upon a plus b plus x is equal to 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by x. Solve for x. What will be the value of x for which this will satisfy? This is solve for x. This is the question. Usually it has been written like this. So what to do? This is a bit different question and difficult as well. So let me explain this. 1 by a plus b plus x. If I can take 1 by x this side minus, that will be 1 by a plus 1 by b remain this side. And now this will come x minus a plus b plus x whole divided by x into a plus b plus x, and that will come up b plus a whole divided by ab. So now after removing this sign, it will be minus of a plus b, minus x cancels out, and here it will be x into a plus b into x will be x square, and now this is b plus a divided by ab. So these two entirely cancels out. Now what will happen? This will multiply this side, so x square plus a plus b into x, and this side it would be minus ab, that is x square plus ax plus bx plus ab is equal to 0. If I would take x common here, x plus a will live. If I would take b common, x plus b will left, and therefore what is that? X plus a will left, and x plus a, I have taken common, it will be x plus b is equal to 0. So either x minus a is equal to 0, x plus a is equal to 0, or x plus b is equal to 0. In both the cases, what will come? X is equal to minus a, or x is equal to minus b. So solution set will be minus a minus b. This is solution set. So answer is this, minus a minus b. So it is easier to solve this, right? I hope you got it. Let me explain some other question. Try to understand what I did here first, then I'll explain one more question. Any one of this term can be taken this side. Not only you, may be it is coming in your mind that why I have taken 1 by x this side, why not 1 by a, why not 1 by b, when, how it come in your mind that what to be taken in this side. It is not a question. You can take it any one of this side. It is not a big issue. If you take any one of them this side, then it will be easier. Why I have taken it? Because some term will be cancelled. If I keep this all together one side, it would be a bit difficult. So let me write another question. Question number 5. This is p square x square, solve for x, plus p square minus q square x minus q square is equal to 0. That is also for solve for x. So I can take here, usually I can take like making factorization. Can I take it like this? P square, p square x minus q square is equal to 0. If I would have taken p square x common, then what will left? P square x I can take common, then x is left only, and what is left here? 1. If I would have taken q square common, what is left here? X. And due to negative sign taken common, that will be positive. Now x plus 1 can be taken from both of them. It will be p square x minus q square is equal to 0. This implies either x plus 1 is equal to 0 or p square x minus q square is equal to 0. In that case, either x is equal to minus 1 or x p square x is equal to q square, and therefore either x is equal to minus 1 or x is equal to q square by p square. So solution set will be minus 1 and q square by p square. That will be the answer of this question. I hope you got it right now. So simple factorization enabled to solve this question quickly, right? So next question, let us see. Next question, what I did here, let me remind once again. This is what I did, just to multiply this both, and I have taken, because it seems that p square can be taken common, x can be taken common, here q square can be taken common, so I have taken just common. It is the simplest form and simple idea in which one can solve. Now question number 6, a square b square x square plus b square x minus a square x minus 1 is equal to 0. Suppose I have to solve this question, then what to do? What to do? And how to solve? If I can write here b square x common from these two terms, can I take? Yes, I can take b square x common. So what is left here? A square, and out of x square, 1x has been taken common, so 1x is left, right? And b square x I have taken common, completely I have taken all b square and x common, so 1 is left here. If I take minus 1 common, then a square x plus 1 will left, sign will change inside the bracket because negative sign has been taken common. Again, if I can take this common, then what will happen? Again, a square x plus 1 can be taken common, then what is left here? B square x minus 1 is equal to 0. And in that way, either a square x plus 1 is equal to 0 or b square x minus 1 is equal to 0. So a square x is equal to minus 1 or b square x is equal to 1. In that case, x is equal to minus 1 by a square or x is equal to 1 by b square. So solution state will be minus 1 by a square and 1 by b square. That will be the answer of this question. So hopefully you got this. Question seems very difficult, but it is quite easy one. You can deal with all such questions. Don't worry about the difficulty. And most of the times, a student feel that in which question there is not 2, 4, 5, 6, 7 are given, but some variables are given or constants are given in terms of A, B, C. They thought the question is very difficult and they are unable to solve. But fact is that whenever this type of variables are given, you can solve it easily without any hassle. So let me discuss another question. That is 4 by x minus 3 is equal to 5 upon 2x plus 3. Here non-negative restrictions are given that x cannot be 0 and x cannot be minus 3 by 2. Because if it would be minus 3 by 2, then that will be 0. And if denominator will be 0, then that function is not defined. So to solve this question, first of all, you have to simplify this and write this in quadratic form. So how to deal with such questions? Let me explain. This is 4 by x minus 5 upon 2x plus 3 is equal to 3. 3 can be taken this side. Now taking LCM, that will be 4 into 2x plus 3 minus 5x divided by x into 2x plus 3 is equal to 3. Now the same thing can be rewrite as 4 to ja. What will be 4 to ja? 4 to ja 8x. 4 3 ja 12 minus 5x is equal to 3 into x into 2x plus 3. So this is what? 8x minus 5x is 3x plus 12 is equal to 3x into 2x plus 3. Now this can be written as, I can cancel this by 3. If I would have taken 3 common, x plus 4 is left and 3x, 2x square, that will come 2x square plus 3x. 3 and 3 cancels out. Now the whole equation will be converted like 2x square plus 3x. X will come this side, it will be negative. 4 will come this side, it will be negative. So the whole thing is 2x square plus 2x minus 4 is equal to 0. Again, if I can divide by 2, x square plus x minus 2 is equal to 0. And finally, this will turn up like x square plus x minus 2 is equal to 0. X square plus x minus 2 is equal to 0. That can be written as x square plus 2x minus x minus 2 is equal to 0. After factorizing it, x, if I would have taken common, x plus 2 minus 1 taken common, then x plus 2 will be 0. Why positive sign? Because negative sign has been taken common. Negative sign has been taken common and therefore inside bracket sign will change. If I would take x plus 2 common, x minus 1 is equal to 0. So either x plus 2 is equal to 0 or x minus 1 is equal to 0. Wherever x plus 2 is equal to 0, x would be minus 2. Or when x minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. In this way, solution set will be what? Minus 2 and 1. These are the answer of this question. Right? So let me solve one more question. Question number 8. So what to do? Today this is the question number 8. That is abx square plus b square minus ac into x minus bc is equal to 0. Can I rewrite this equation? Yes, I can write it abx square plus b square x minus acx minus bc is equal to 0. What can be taken common out of these two? B can be taken. Right now? We can take B common. We can also take X common. So B and X can be taken common. So BX can be taken common. What is left here? B has been taken. A is left. Out of X square, X has been taken. So X is left. Out of B square, 1B has been taken. So B is left. And X has been taken. So no X. Now, out of these two, what can be taken common? C is present in both. So we can take common C. What is left here? AX. But negative sign has been taken common. So inside bracket, sign will change. Out of BC, C has been taken common. What is left? B. That is equal to 0. So in that way, AX plus B present in both the factors, both the terms. So I can take AX plus B common out of these two. What is left here? BX minus C is equal to 0. So in that way, either AX plus B is equal to 0 or BX minus C is equal to 0. Right? Either AX plus B is equal to 0 or BX minus C is equal to 0. In that way, AX is equal to minus B or BX is equal to C. So X is equal to minus B by A or X is equal to C by A, and therefore solution set will be, solution set is minus B by A and C by A. That will be answer of this question. So simple idea is that whenever such questions are given, don't worry about this. You just separate them, take maximum possible common. Definitely it will be a prize form, and you will be able to solve all those questions in quick seconds. I hope you got it. What I did here, let me remind this. ABX square, B square X, so I have written. ACX I have written, minus BC. Clear indication that out of these two, BX can be taken common. Out of these two, C can be taken common. And whenever you took this, something left inside the bracket, it's similar. And now you can take X plus B common, BX left from here, C left from there. And now these are two linear factors whose product is 0. So one of them is definitely 0. And in that way, you will be able to analyze the value of X. What will be the value of X? That can be determined, and that will be the solution of this question. So hopefully, you are able to understand all these things. Some more questions we will discuss in the next class. Till then, watch our all the videos and subscribe our channel Avancing Academy on YouTube, and visit our website www.avancing.com. And till then, we are leaving this class. Bye bye. Thank you. Thank you very much.